preset for a thumbnail. My thumbnail. You guys, when I'm editing and I'm looking at my thumbnails, I look like a legit crazy person in 99% of the frames. So finding a usable thumbnail is really quite a challenge for me. Just my own problems. So got the oven on, baking the second cake of the day. We made this lemon pound cake with the kids' school today. They've started doing a bake-along on Fridays. So I actually made two cakes. One, this one, made this morning with Donnie. And then the bake-along, in fact, there is my timer. Let me go check on it. Yeah, that is not even close to done, but that one looks much better than my first attempt. And I got some text messages. Okay, let's set the timer for 15 minutes. And let's just... okay, the second cake Cece and I baked in a Zoom meeting with like half of the school and one of her teachers, which was so fun, which we did last week too. The thing is that Donnie loves baking way more than Cece. Cece enjoys it, but Donnie loves it. And I think he felt really left out last Friday because when they have the time of the meeting for the bake-along, he's still asleep 98% of the time. He's still napping. So I made it with him this morning, also because I knew it was a two-step thing. It takes an hour and a half to bake, and I wanted Cece to be able to glaze the cake with me in the bake-along. So yeah, we made the pound cake. Looks good, smells good, and I don't mind having two because it's actually my mom's birthday this weekend, and the kids and I are gonna drive over to their house tomorrow and drop off the cake and some champagne and some cards and wish her a happy birthday from the car, which is really sad, but that's that. But I'm happy that at least we can't drive, like they're close enough we can drive over and like wave at them from the car. But yeah, it is kind of a bummer. But anyway, this video will go up long after that because I'm way behind on my posting, but happy birthday, Mom. We love you. We miss seeing you in person. I kind of felt like vlogging. I have not felt like picking up a camera in almost 2 full weeks. That was the last time I vlogged was Easter. So that was almost 2 full weeks ago at the time that I'm filming this now. And I have been just really pulled back from everything. Not only like publicly, but in my private life, I've just kind of pulled inward. I needed some time to think about some things and consider some things. And I have a video, it's one of those that I filmed. I don't do this often, but every once in a while I'll film a really personal video that I won't post. I really don't do this that often. But I think I probably will post it where I'm talking more about the feelings, all the feelings. And today is the first day in almost 2 weeks that I feel, how to put this in a way that doesn't make me sound like a complete jerk face. Yeah, I struggle. You guys, I struggle with the, like, am I allowed to have feelings and express them because I live a cushy, privileged life? I think the answer is yes for everybody else, but I have a very, very difficult and long, torturous, self-torturous history with that question for myself, because I don't feel like I not only can express those feelings or that I can even have them. Like, I feel wrong for having them. I have worked through years of therapy and I'm doing a lot of work right now on that specifically. And what I'm coming out with is, yes, have all the feelings and share them as you want. Because I have said this recently and I will say it until I am blue in the face. It is that tough stuff. Those raw moments and feelings and experiences that are so human And so it's what connects us, and we're afraid to talk about them for fear of ruffling feathers or, you know, looking bad or whatever, shame coming at you or throwing at yourself, or, and it's like, for what? Then we just keep each other apart from each other out of fear. And I'm just done with that. I'm so sick of it. I don't want to do it anymore. I don't want to live this disconnected, disjointed life anymore. I don't. And if that means pissing off some people, I don't know if that's swearing, but I apologize. I do swear, you guys. The swearing's gonna come out more, not in the videos, but I'll talk more about that another time. I think I gotta live unapologetically somewhat. I don't know. It's a process. Anyway, long story short, because you know me, I cannot talk and succinctly at all. I'm feeling rejuvenated and like more alive today and more just today. And I've been feeling really for a couple of weeks. And it's been like, it's been intense, man. I have been intensely inward. And today, I literally bumped my head, something in my, people are gonna think I like injured myself. I didn't. I hit my head on a shelf, but it's like, I don't know, almost instantly I like, the fog cleared. I saw some things clearly. I have a path I'm so excited about. More about that to come. And I'm just feeling lifted. Things are still crappy, but I feel lifted. Anywho, I'm filming. I'm vlogging. I don't know where this will go. I don't really have a point for this. I did have one point. I wanted to do my unboxing a little bit of the Erin Condren PR goodies on camera. That's all these three big boxes, because I am going to post a review, which will more than likely go up well before this video. But I thought some of you, even the non-planner people, sometimes like just to see me open stuff. I'm like, I can open stuff. Let's open stuff. So, I might have to break for the cake in a minute. Let me adjust the camera down so you guys can see. I have three, let's see, how's that? Well, then you can't see my reactions. How are we gonna do this? Also, hi, pimples, please be nice. I've been really struggling with my self-esteem and my face lately. Just don't be jerks. I know most of you aren't. And thank you for that. But to the few who are like, like, just shut it. Anyway, I have three packages and you still cannot see me. Well, that's the best I can do. Three boxes. One of them, I think this yellow one, is an order I placed. So let's open that first. This is not sent to me. I purchased it. And it's the Erin Condren masks. And I bought several to give, one to my mom, one to my sister-in-law, one to my mother-in-law. They're kind of girly, so I don't know. I bought these other ones. I thought maybe I'd give this one to my dad. He could rock it. The other, I don't know about the other men. One for me, obviously. I don't have a mask. I had actually ordered one from the apron making company. Is it Hatley and something or other? Because they had this thing where they're giving, you know, you buy one, they donate one. That kind of thing, which I thought was really nice. But anyway. So, these are $12. These are not inexpensive. They are made in the USA. They have the wiring in them. I do have like referral credits from my referral days with EC. So I don't, like, I bought them with my referral credits. Okay, so we'll just put it there. I have never worn a mask. Ever. This is my first time ever putting one on. Oh, this is nice how it like warms to your nose. This is weird. I don't like this. Oh my god, I feel so claustrophobic. This is gonna take some getting used to. Okay, so obviously I'm gonna wash these. By the way, these packages have been sitting in my house since Tuesday and it's Friday. So I'm sure they're fine, whatever they are, but I will wash them. This is nice, the elastic is nice. I think they're nice quality. I think my family will enjoy them. and use them. I mean, we just need them right now. I have very complicated feelings about the masks. And now the governor of Illinois has just decreed, it used to be that children 5 and over were supposed to wear them in places where they couldn't social distance more than 6 feet apart. And now they're saying as of, I think, May 1st, 2 and over, so that means both my kids qualify. I did purchase them masks on Etsy, little like frozen ones, which I haven't even taken out of the packaging yet. I just have this terribly sinking feeling that if they're gonna go back to school at all this calendar year, I know we're not going back this school year, but that they're gonna have to wear masks at school. And I'm just, you guys, the masks, this is gonna bring me down a little bit from feeling good, but the masks trigger me. And I don't know why. I don't have any like traumatic story of like being in the hospital or anything like that that would set me off, but they trigger me. And I'm still unpacking that and what that means, but just seeing people, like not even wearing it, I just get claustrophobic with anything over my like neck and mouth, but seeing people wear masks, I literally haven't been in a store in a couple of weeks. My Whole Foods released pickup as an option. We've been doing that once a week instead of going into the store. And so I've absolutely avoided going anywhere where I need to be surrounded by people in masks because they just make me feel really triggered. But anyway, those are nice. I'll put a link to those below if you guys want to see. Okay. The rest of these boxes are the PR boxes. I'm pretty sure this is the binder. They sent it separately because they sent it like a little bit later than the rest. Whoa, I probably should not have done that to the box, but it probably went through worse in shipping. I feel like it's so dark. Hold on. I'm trying to figure out like how to film this where you can see my reaction. I don't know why I suddenly decided my reaction is what you really want to see in this whole thing. But I figure since you've already seen me review the products, if you watched that video, that you don't need to see the reaction. This is, it says, my team and I, at the end of the storm is a rainbow. My team and I are working hard to create products that truly help you get organized and adjust to this new normal. I have feelings about the new normal phrase, by the way. No shade. From kids' notebooks to help at home learning to planners to keep track of meal planning, to do lists and gratitude, we strive to be a bright spot in a series of dark days. I can't tell you how much we appreciate your business. We truly are better together. I know we will get through this. That's a really nice heartfelt message, and I actually really appreciate that. All right, these products all sent to me for PR. And it is the new stuff. Wow. Oh my gosh. Okay, there's one planner box, and they brought back the flimsy box again. Well, they added a tiny bit of reinforcement to it, but it's the same frickin' box, essentially. Okay. You guys know how I feel about the box. But the planner, like, screw the box. The planner is beautiful. So it looks like they sent me the one that I requested, and then I think people have been getting the daily as well. So it looks like they sent me the one I requested and the daily. So, oh my gosh. I love the color palette on this. Look how beautiful. So I asked for the hourly in neutral. Oh, here's the little pack with your coupon codes and all that jazz. So that's standard. This will be all in the review, so I'm not gonna go into too much detail. Beautiful, the paper feels lovely. Have enough courage to start and enough heart to finish. I love that. This is all very similar, like structure, I would say, skeleton, to last year. Ooh, the paper feels slightly different this year. I wonder if they changed it a little. It almost feels like a little synthetic, but in like a good way. Oh, look at that. They listened to the complaints. People were so PO'd that the tab did not open to the month, and I didn't really notice it until I started using the hourly myself this year, and I was like, oh, you're right. They sent me a gold coil. Ick. Do not want a gold coil. I wanted a rose gold coil. Well, I guess I'll be ordering that. That's okay. There are worse things. But I do not. Like, it's lovely if you like gold, but I wanted a rose gold coil. The rose gold coil will look so nice with this. That's such a bummer. All right, what can you do? So anyway, they put the productivity page on the next page, which is smart to move that. And I've already heard through the grapevine that they changed the hourly to include half hours again, from 6 a.m. to 7 p.m. The paper feels different, man. It does. This is beautiful. I really love the layers design. I like how there's not a lot of fluff here. I'm not seeing any big hexagons or anything. Just real streamlined. Very nice. They listened to feedback and they changed some things. So that's good. Okay. That was like my 1 minute analysis of that. I am really bummed that I did not get the rose gold coil. That is a bummer. Here, I'm guessing this guy is the daily. July through December 2020 daily. This is brand new, a coil daily. Ooh, the colorful is beautiful. That is gorgeous. I love that. Wow. This feels wrong, doesn't it? This looks wrong. I feel like this is a mistake. I feel like I'm missing some pages here, but that's okay. Hopefully they'll work out all of those oopsies before launch. Interesting. So days of the week have a similar timestamp to the hourly. Looks just like the petite daily planner, but larger with timestamps on it. Weekend on one page. But the rest of it is gorgeous, and I know people will appreciate having the daily. Oh, this colorful is so beautiful. I almost want to just coil some of the element, make a Franken planner. I kind of want to do it. So there's two of those in the daily duo. I'm sure I'll go into more detail. This is my first time seeing this stuff. I haven't even watched any reviews because I wanted everything to be just fresh for me. There's a petite planner monthly planner, a new one. Let's open that up. I still use petite planners even though I don't use it as a planning system. I use them for journaling and note taking. Whoa, girl. Oh, this is just like the usual. This is really nice. I like how they brought back the, I forget what that pattern is called. It's nice. Okay, so this is July through December of 2021. This is a year and a half. So it has the year and a half calendars at the front and then just a dot grid at the back and your stickers. That's very nice. Kind of want to keep everything. I'm just going to keep it out of packaging. Then we got some accessories. I have this snap-in dashboard. Ooh, a new sticker book. We'll have to look through that. I don't know what these are. Just some fun stickers for fun. A planning pouch. I bet the colorful version of this is even prettier. There are some new compliment cards. I never use these mini snap-ins, but I know some people like them. I mean, it's just pretty. It's pretty stuff. I saw this, the pen, the interchangeable pen thing. I saw it on the internet, on the Instagram. My planner friends have been posting about it. I don't love it. If I want to use a marker, I want it to be a whole marker that I can use without taking the time to set it up. That's just me personally, but that's me being nitpicky. Okay, so exciting. Oh, and there's something else. This looks like a pen. Let's see. I bet this is a pen for sure. I'm so bummed they did not send the rose gold coil. Oh well. Pen. Okay, that's that. Let's look at the binder. If you watched my review from last year, you know that I was not, I don't want to say I was not kind. I was very truthful about that binder. I did not think it was up to snuff. Same card. Here we go. The same little stuff. And okay, it looks like a nicer fabric. same size. I know people were kind of hoping that they would do the A5, but they did not. How do you open this? My goodness, that is shoved in there. Okay. It's like a coated canvas. Okay, it has a bit of a sheen to it. Is this supposed to be champagne? I would call this a different color than that. But the gold on the inside. Well, the rings seem better. I'll give them that. It does feel, okay, right off the bat, it does feel slightly more sturdy. So I'll give them that. Here's the punch. You guys, this is a single page punch. I'm just gonna leave that there. And then the guts. So apparently you can, this year, I think, again, I haven't done my research on this yet. I have to do that before I sit down for my video. But I think what you can do is order different guts. All the different layouts. I think I could do that last year too, but the vellum page is nice. Wow, this is a long video. This is the vertical layout in the new Flower Power. It's really hard to show you without clipping it into the binder, but well, don't love that. I guess if you get the Flower Power, it's because you want a lot of doodads on every page. If you want a lot of doodads, oh my freaking goodness. Don't even. How? Oh my gosh. You guys, how? How did they do this again? This is punched for the coil, not the rings. This makes no sense to me. All right, you did it once. It was a mistake. How did they do it again? Is this intentional? No planner is gonna be perfect, okay, you guys? It's a fact. I'm not a manufacturer. I never claim to be. I'm sure there's a lot of ins and outs to manufacturing that I do not and will never understand because I'm not a manufacturer. But I do not understand how you can make that, to me, is a mistake. That's a design mistake, and to repeat it a second year in a row, especially when it's been pointed out to your team, like I know they know that we all noticed that. It's not like nobody said anything and so it just went through again. I do not understand that. I don't. And I hold EC up to a very, very high standard because they have high standard products. High quality, beautiful products that are obviously designed with a lot of thought and care. And for them to not fix that, that bothers me. Okay, well, there it is. I think this went in there and I forgot. That is my initial reaction to the, this is not gonna close, to the planner situation this year. I'm excited about the paper. I'm excited about the design. I think it's really nice. I think they did a really, really nice job with the like planner structure in terms of looking at what wasn't working. I mean, I only have the neutral hourly to show you, but to looking at what wasn't working. I wish I had more planners to show you, but I understand they can only send what they can send, and I'm grateful for what they sent, and thank you. Thank you to the EC team, especially Sam, for thinking of me, including me in this, because I know I am like the black sheep of the influencer list. I know I am. I know I do not play by the rules, you guys. I do not post when I'm encouraged to post. I don't. I only share if I feel like it. Like, I don't play by the rules, and they still send me stuff. And I think that is a testament of a good faith, because I say it like it is with the planners. I don't feel the need to sugarcoat anything. Not that anybody does, but just that's my, I'm gonna tell you, I think that coil punching the folder and stickers for the binder is an atrocious error. I can't even call it an error this year because they did it again and they knew about it. So to me, it's like, it's intentional. And I'm like, why? I can't think of why. What is the point? All right, I bet this cake is almost done. It's got to be almost done. Oh, I did not set that right. Oh gosh. Oh, it looks beautiful. Okay, let's see. I don't even know if I'm in the frame, you guys, but I'll just edit this out. I'm not. Looks beautiful. It's not quite ready anyway, so that's fine. Okay. We'll just let that go, I think, another 10 minutes. Okay. Anywho, I'm gonna clip off here. And yeah, clearly I don't have the children right now. This is kind of random, but they're not with me this evening. So I have a little time and space to film freely, but yeah, plans for the evening to finish this cake. Maybe do some, I did not do my yoga. I did not do my dance today. I've been really moving my body a lot because it's helping me a lot with the feeling, all the feelings. So I might do some of those things. I'm gonna take Winnie for a nice long walk this evening and maybe take a bath. We'll see. That's the plan.
Good morning. I woke up with horrible cramps. I have had really horrible cramping and very heavy periods since my period returned, I don't know, a year ago? Has it been a year? More than a year ago. It's not so severe that I feel like I need to do anything about it necessarily, but it's been a year since I had my annual with my OB. I was supposed to go in like a couple weeks ago for my annual, and obviously we postponed that because of all that's going on. Any non-necessary things. So I think I'm supposed to go in July or something now. I don't remember. It was rescheduled. Anyway, so but when I saw her last year, I had only had like one or two cycles of my period and they hadn't settled into anything yet. So I didn't, you know, so anyway, long story short, it's something I do plan on bringing up with her. I'm not like really concerned. It's just unfortunate that it's just so much like pain, like, you know, like it's crazy. Like there's a couple of days where it's like, I can't even believe how much can come out of a person. Anyway, that was way TMI, so we'll leave that there. When I am heavily cramping, I try not to do any, like literally cannot do any intensive exercising really at all when I'm cramping. The like, rate of flow doesn't affect me too much. Like, I don't care about that with exercise, but if I'm cramping and I don't feel well, then I don't. So I'm gonna hope that the cramps subside a little. I might dance a little bit during resting time later today, but I'm just gonna not do my usual kick my butt first thing in the morning routine today. But I'm just wondering if anybody else who's had kids, if their period changed significantly when they started having regular periods again. I want to say I always had cramping issues unless I was on the pill. And I was on the pill for like over a decade in my 20s. So like from 17 to 27, I was on the pill. So I didn't have issues then. Everything was hunky-dory. It was when I went off the pill and then I got the hormonal adult acne and the really bad cramping and all of that. But it's more like what's changed post having babies. It's just how the like output quantity has increased. I'm just curious. Can we not, I mean, why can't we talk about these things without like disclaiming and feeling like weird about it? This is totally normal stuff that women go through. Anyway, that's just another part of learning how to be gentle with myself. Not pushing through pain. Like, you do not have to push through pain, Jen. If you hurt, don't push through it. Like, just be easy with yourself. You guys, I'm telling you, I am learning. You can teach a 37-year-old new things. Anyway, onward with the day.
The kids and I are bringing my mom a party in a bag. So we've got champagne in that bad boy right there. And then some Erin Condren face masks. And a lemon pound cake we baked. And some candles and a card. And I also had arranged for some flowers to be delivered to her. So best we can do with the social distancing. But hopefully she'll feel celebrated. So satisfying.
Got some weird lighting first thing in the morning in this spot. Oh, I spilled some of my foam. It's like that weird Instagram filter with the like, I am in the real Instagram filter. Wow. I don't know if I can film here. Is this too distracting? If we go over here, it's worse. Whatever, we'll go with it. Good morning. I really don't. Ooh, that is so good. Hold on. Hold on. First sip of coffee. I obviously haven't had my coffee yet. I don't really know what this vlog is. It's just like a weird collection of my ramblings. Maybe that's what I'll call it. That's an enticing clickbaity title, isn't it? Oh, just what I want to watch. A weird collection of Jen's thoughts. So it's Sunday and the kids just left for their dad's. And I have actually already put in a full hour workout, which I have not been doing on Sundays. I have not been waking up early, but I went to bed early last night and I woke up early this morning because I'm realizing, and more on this at some point, that the earlier I go to bed, the better I feel, regardless of when I wake up. And it doesn't seem to make a difference if I wake up at 5 or if I wake up at 6:30. If I am asleep by 10, I feel the same at 5 or 6:30 in the morning. And what that feeling is a heck of a lot better than how I was feeling going to bed at 11, maybe even 12, and waking up between 5 and 6:30. So yeah. I've also started just this weekend a very, very quick 5-minute yoga stretch after I get up and get dressed and brush my teeth. And then I do a 5-minute meditation. I have been doing this experiment for the month of April where I try to sit and meditate for 5 minutes a day. And I've been doing it after my daily yoga practice. But now I'm starting to do it in the morning too. I think ultimately what will work best for me if I do this 2 to 3 times a day. And it's 5 minutes, okay? I literally set the timer on my watch for 5 minutes and it just gently buzzes when the 5 minutes is up and I sit and I just sit, right? But yeah, that, I don't know. I think it's something I wanted to do for a long time and I'm trying it and we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Anyway, I feel like I haven't been looking at the situation, but did the rainbow filter go away? I think so. Anyway, yeah, I feel like my mood is just like, I, no matter So the day can get derailed, right? But at least when I wake up in the morning, if I have fallen asleep before 10 o'clock, I'm waking up in a much more positive mood. And that's huge. That's really big, because I have not been waking up in a feeling very great in this whole corn time. I heard somebody say that today. I was like, that's funny, corn time. But yeah. And it seems like I'm like, sometimes, more often than not, I am woken up several times between like 10 and 2 by children or animals needing my assistance with something. And even those like sleep disruptions don't seem to negatively impact my mood as long as I've initially fallen asleep before 10. Even if I'm woken up like literally a couple nights ago, I fell asleep before 10, I was woken up at 10:30, and then 11:30, and then 12:30, and then 1:30 by different small beings needing me. And I woke up at 5 next morning and I felt great. And then I don't know what the day turned into, but I started out the day good. So just trying to implement some experiments in this time and kind of figure out like where my groove is. So what's on the docket for today? I do want to do a little bit more exercising kinds of things, just for fun, because I have a little bit more time and space to do that. So I'll probably do a work routine, the dance cardio fitness. I'll probably do some sort of toning, from Core Power, because I have been slacking a little bit on that, and I don't want to lose my muscles, you know? But the main plan for today is that, not the cabinet, the Erin Condren boxes. I need to, film and edit my review to try to get it up tomorrow in time for, insider launch at least. I don't know. You guys, I'm always so excited. Like, this is Christmas to me, is getting the new planner and being able to film it and share my thoughts with you. It's like, it is the best. It's one of my favorite things to film. I look forward to it every year. And especially this year, because I'm back in an EC, like an actual life planner. I've been using the hourly, except not during this quarantine. Although I might kind of dip my toes back into planning, just because I don't know, this is endless. So yeah, I need to reinsert some structure in that way. But I feel so conflicted about filming and sharing that kind of content right now. I don't feel conflicted about other people doing it. I'm like, ooh, cool, reviews, awesome. And I know like a lot of you guys would be like, ooh, yay, a review, or it's not your thing, you'd be like, yeah, let's get that one. But I personally just feel like, oh my gosh, it just doesn't feel right. I'm having this like internal moral battle. But I did make a commitment to, film it. And it's not, I never like sign anything or promise anything, but I've been working with the EC team for years on, you know, just in a really, really like good relationship with them. And I told them I would love to see the new planners and that I would film a review. I don't often make that promise. I don't ever make that promise. I didn't promise, but usually 99.9% of the time I say, yeah, send me whatever you want. I don't guarantee a review. But I knew going into it that I would obviously film a review of this. So I was like, yeah, I'll film a review. And now it's been a lot of things have happened since then. And now I'm like, oh my gosh, I don't know like how, I just feel weird. I just need to get over myself and just film it. I think I'm just being like a little too in my head about it. But those are my feelings. I'm guessing by the time this video is up, that will already be posted. So I'll link it if you want to see it. Just even that feels so weird. I feel I don't know what the right thing to post is right now. That's why I've been making like these random vlogs of just my feelings and ramblings and weird things that are going on. Because I don't know what else to film. Filming like my normal stuff feels really weird. I filmed an unboxing last week, but it was like about things that I've bought during quarantine time. So it felt like, I don't know, current? Filming a planner review to me right now feels very just off. But maybe it will provide me with a little bit of escape from the like internal, I mean just the arguing in my head is deafening, and I'm just like, okay, can you pipe down a little bit? Because I just want to breathe a little bit and focus on something else for just a minute. And I don't think it's irresponsible, because majority of the time I am really thinking about all of the badness and sadness and awfulness, and there's so much dread and everything, and just so it's not like I'm not thinking about those things. It's not like I'm living in la la land and I'm just not like plugged into reality. Oh, I am plugged in. That's why I took such a big break from posting and from social media. This is getting weirder, the lighting. I like, there we go. But now you've got the cabinet. I'm like hiding over here. Anyway, ramble aside, this is gonna be like the longest. Oh, hi Robin. Oh, bye Robin. There was a little bird. Anyway, that's where I'm at. So this is probably like the lamest vlog ever, because I'm not showing anything I'm doing. I'm just yapping my trap, but there it is. I'm gonna have some breakfast. I'm gonna get the pup out. He's here for a nice warm walk. It's gonna be sunny-ish today, so we'll take it and we'll get this party started. Even though this party's been going for 3 hours already. So yeah, this is happening, but I'm having technical difficulties because I don't know why my battery isn't properly charging for my Sony RX. I was hoping to film right away and I had it plugged in for so long and it's not working. So I think I got it right now. I don't know. The light was flashing. Technical difficulties, you guys don't care. But anyway, I usually film this sort of stuff in my office. My office is absolutely atrociously messy. Piles of stuff everywhere, so I'm attempting to film it in the kitchen today. I just brought my rig downstairs. I like to use this camera for overheads because it's just sharper focus. I like the Canon's general vlog quality better for like the tone of the picture and the quality of the sound. Stuff nobody cares about but me. But anyway, I think what I'm gonna do is pop Winnie out for a walk. You guys, I put makeup on for the first time in like 6 weeks. And I'm like, if I go for a walk, is it not gonna look as nice? Like I blew my hair dry? This is not what I've been doing lately, but that needs time to charge. So I guess we're going out and we'll just have to deal with it.
Many hours later.
The aftermath. You guys, I could not get my other camera to work. I couldn't get the battery to charge. I don't know what's going on with that. And I had so much trouble filming this. I am dreading looking at the footage because I fear that most of it is out of focus. That's really why I like using the other camera. It's just snappier focus when it comes to detailed things like products. Canon, this camera does fine with faces, but it's just not as good at picking up details, especially stationary products and things with like writing on them. So that's gonna be really frustrating. But basically that's the rest of my day, is gonna be editing this beast. It's lunchtime now, so I'm gonna take a little break and let the footage, I'm gonna pull the footage off the, oh, I hope I don't have to refilm anything. Anyway, that's what's happening, y'all. So it took me a couple hours probably to get everything set up to film and film it, and it's gonna take me several hours to edit it.
And hopefully the video will be under 45 minutes. That's my goal. But I don't really ever limit myself, as you know, with my video length.
Good morning, guys. Just turning on the coffee machine. The kids are gonna be here literally any second. I did not wrap up this video yesterday. What hair? Don't care. I don't know. Just life. What a weird vlog. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just filming stuff that I feel like and posting it. Hoping that it's at least somewhat interesting to somebody. Anyway, if you watch this, thank you for watching. I appreciate you. And I'm thinking of you, and my heart is with yours. We're making it through this, you guys. It's not fun for anybody. And I am really, really, truly sorry if you are directly impacted by either having the virus or knowing someone, loving someone who has it, or any of those things. It's just devastating, and I want you to know that I am thinking of you, and I'm with you in spirit and in heart. And we're getting through this. We're gonna get through this. We're doing it. Every day is a new day that we've done it for another day. And there will be another side to this. There will. So I will see you in the meantime. Bye, guys. Thanks for watching. Take care.